Bycott. With us this morning is Philip Dennis, who's actually traveled from Dallas to be with us this morning to take part and help organize the rally. And we also have Bob Thomas, who is a local business owner. So thank you both for being here this morning.
A pleasure.
Let's start off with tell me a little bit more about tonight's event taking place at Tempe Diablo Stadium.
Well, I'm with the Dallas Tea Party and pretty involved in the Tea Party movement. We saw a tremendous amount of support for 1070 and Arizona. We saw when the various boycotts started taking place is that we decided it was time for our side of the equation to be heard and our voices to be heard. And so we put together a boycott for people to come from all over the country to come in and support Arizona's economy over the Memorial Day weekend, spending tons of money to put money into the to counter the effects of the boycott from some of the other liberal cities and states.
And how many folks are you expecting today?
It's hard to say, but it's going to be thousands and thousands. I know we have people from as far away as Philadelphia and Chicago that have come in, and tons of people are coming over from California and New Mexico, mm-hmm. my state of Texas. So.
And everyone's got to be looking at the timing. What about the timing of this? Because it's the same day, of course, as the protest against 1070 that's happening right now.
Our event's been planned for over 2 months.
Really?
So,
okay.
Yeah, in fact, I didn't even know about the other event until I got here on Thursday.
Okay, yeah. So it's interesting to see both sides really coming out today on this specific day. Certainly all eyes here nationally on the state of Arizona. Bob, talk a little bit about your standpoint. You're a local business owner. When you started hearing about the boycott of Arizona because of SB 1070, what were your thoughts?
Well, first thought was, you know, if we're going to live in glass houses, we shouldn't throw stones. I personally took offense at Seattle's council to vote 7-0 to try to harm the economy, my street, my neighborhood, you know, my town where I live. I wrote them a letter and said, you know, if you want to take that approach, then I will start diverting all of the incoming freight away from the port in Seattle mm-hmm. in response to it, also to LA as well. If they want to boycott our state and try to tell us what to do, stick their nose in our business, I'm totally going to do everything I can to have a bigger club than they do.
What do you think about having the boycott this weekend and the events this evening?
I'm totally in support of it. Mm-hmm. I think that we should welcome with open arms people that are coming from all over the country to stand with Arizona. Mm-hmm. If we don't stand up, who will?
I know Sheriff Joe Arpaio is one of the featured guests, a controversial man himself, of course, and he'll be there tonight as well. Tell me what else will be going on.
We have a lot of speakers and entertainment. It's going to be a really fun event. But again, the whole purpose of this was to let the people of Arizona know that the Americans stand with them. We're seeing now the polls show that over 70% of Americans support SB 1070. There's legislation in over 17 states mm-hmm. now. So we just think Arizona started the ball rolling. So we want to let them know the common sense citizens of America stand with Arizona. So we're going to have musical entertainment. We're going to have some reenactors from some of our founding fathers, Sheriff Arpaio, as you mentioned, and other speakers who are just are affected by either illegal immigration and the effects of that and or the boycott from other states.
What do you say to folks who are against SB 1070 are saying this will promote racism, this will promote racial profiling?
Well, I say it's ludicrous personally. Yeah, I'm happen to be married to a legal immigrant. My wife is from Colombia, and we went through the proper steps. This all boils down to us: are we a country that follows the rule of law, mm-hmm. or are we not? And if we're not, then we should avoid paying taxes or traffic laws or anything of that nature. Where do you draw the line? And I know personally, when I'm pulled over by the police for a traffic stop, they ask for my identification. I give it to them. My wife, everywhere she goes, she carries her green card with you. If you follow the rules, if you follow our laws that have been created by Washington, as well as now in Arizona, you have nothing to worry about.
Well, we thank you both for taking the time this morning to join us this morning. Again, the event tonight, the Stand By Arizona boycott happening at 6:30 this evening at Tempe Diablo Stadium, and the information on azfamily.com if you'd like to be a part of that. Thank you, gentlemen, for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
When we come back, we're going to take a fresh look of news for you, so stay with us. We'll be right back.